Well, the ways of a man seem right unto him, but the end thereof is death because of sin. And the scriptures say that there's only one way for a man to be saved from this wicked state. You must be born again by the Holy Ghost. This, my friends, is the only way for a man to be saved from sin and death and be a partaker of holiness. Now Jesus Christ was born in Bethlehem, the Son of God and the Son of Man. And at the age of 30 he began to preach the kingdom of God throughout Galilee. He raised up the dead, he turned the water to wine, he gave hearing to the deaf and sight to the blind. He did signs and wonders throughout the lands, did mighty miracles by his gentle hands. But the people, they did not understand that this was the Messiah that was promised to them. And they crucified him upon a tree, and in their ignorance they killed the Lord of glory. But he raised himself up, showed himself unto man, then he ascended up into heaven. Now people, time is running short, and Jesus coming soon. He's gonna come down from the skies. He's gonna wage war in righteousness. He's gonna judge this world by the sword of his lips, and every eye is gonna see him. Even those that pierced him and the families of this earth are gonna wail because of him. So turn around, turn away from your sins, and walk a straight path, a path of holiness. Mortify the flesh and the deeds thereof, and serve the Lord my God out of fear and love. Take up the cross and follow him, and he will make you to be fishers of men. Or deny yourself and the pleasures of sin, and be a partaker of his suffering. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. Draw nigh unto God and he'll draw nigh to you. Take a look at this world, what a wicked place. Just take a look at the state of the human race. Take a good look around, it's not hard to see the results of sin and iniquity. Just turn a television on or look at a front page. It's there before your eyes every single day. There's murder and there's rape and crime's on the rise, and it's waxing worse and worse right before our eyes. Self-righteousness, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes and the pride of life. But I'm here today to help you understand the ways of God are not the ways of man. He's a righteous God, holy and true, and his promises are faithful to me and you. He's the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and end. Behold, he's gonna make all things new again. He's gonna take away the sorrow, gonna take away the pain. He's gonna take away the lying, gonna take away the dying, gonna wipe the tears away from our eyes. Gonna bring the new Jerusalem down from the sky. Gonna make a new heaven, gonna make a new earth, where righteousness dwells and there'll be no more curse. There'll be no more.